Oi, gente, tudo bem? Aqui é a Isa e no vídeo de hoje eu trago uma nova entrevista aqui no canal da Toda Team. Eu acabei de conversar com Bailey Madison e Kevin Quinn, que são os protagonistas de A Semana da Minha Vida, novo filme da Netflix que chega lá na plataforma no dia 26 de março. Essa é uma escolha para quem curte bastante aqueles filmes com a vibe bem camp rock, sabe? Porque tem as histórias dos adolescentes, mas também tem um lado musical que a gente gosta. E basicamente, em A Semana da Minha Vida, nós acompanhamos a história de Will, que é um garoto rebelde, que ele precisa fazer uma escolha. Ou ele tem que ir para um centro de detenção juvenil, ou ele tem que ir para um acampamento cristão. E ele acaba escolhendo fazer essa viagem. Por lá é onde essa história se desenvolve e onde vemos a relação dele nascendo com Avery. E nessa entrevista nós podemos conversar com eles para entender como que foi gravar essas cenas no acampamento, esse lado mais divertido que o filme traz, quais foram as músicas favoritas deles do filme inteiro, e ainda a Bailey contou pra gente como que foi coproduzir o filme, além de participar atuando. Mas antes de conferir esse bate-papo, não se esqueça de se inscrever aqui no canal, deixar o seu like e bora lá! First of all, I would like to congratulate you guys on this movie. It's amazing.
Thank you so much. Great meeting you, Isabella.
And I wanted to start by asking Bailey, how was the experience of participating in a musical film and also be a co-producer?
Oh, it was like one of the most gratifying and most exciting moments, I think, of my life. When I first signed on to be a part of it, I just strictly came in as an actress, and I fell in love with Avery, and I loved the story, and was obviously so excited when they told me that, Kevin was playing Will. And just all the pieces started falling into place. And I grew up always wanting to do music, but it just never really happened where I could share it publicly. And so I was really excited to finally have that chance within this movie. But I had produced in the past, and that's a part of my brain that's really hard to turn off. And I love being a part of that process. So thankfully, the guys let the 19-year-old at a time, who was a girl, have a seat at the table. And we just collaborated so much from, the scenes to the stories and to the little moments in there. It's been such a joy, and especially now that we found our home at Netflix, it's been like so satisfying for me to get to be hands-on in the behind-the-scenes process as a whole. Very, very humbled and grateful.
And Kevin, what were the biggest challenges for you to be acting and also dancing and singing in the movie?
It was challenging the rehearsal process and learning those things at first, but I am proud that I kind of have a strong suit when it comes to putting the two together. So I don't know, I just have a very good sense of awareness for my body and music as well.
He killed it. He was great always.
Appreciate
We
it.
can see that you both were really great. Now, a curiosity that I had while watching the movie, what were the favorite musics of the movie for you guys?
I always enjoyed the dive sequence. I feel like the energy is kind of like a climax when it comes to the dancing, and that song is just so great in the way they executed that song. And then also Best Thing Ever reprise, just because that really is the climax of the movie, the very end, and we get to see some of these relationships have a resolution. And
Maybe, who knows? You should watch it. There might be no resolutions.
not. But I like both those numbers for sure.
I do too, Kevin. I love Best Thing Ever. I think it's so fun. Dive was a blast. They all were a blast for me. I am a big fan of the Place in This World. Just because it was the first day of filming, it was literally the first time Kevin and I had been on screen together and the first musical number that we did. So there's something really special and sacred about those scenes and those shots.
And besides the music perspective, the film also brings several moments of you enjoying the summer with games and dynamics. And I was wondering, what was it like for you to record those moments? Is the fun that we see in the movie something that went beyond acting?
Oh yeah.
I forgot the cameras were rolling on those, which I
All
don't think that's a good or a bad thing. There was a spirit of competition on those particular days, but I feel like it just brought out this realness to the whole field day activities.
day. Our hair and makeup team were so lovely, but they'd come over and they'd be like, "We get it. You're having a great time. You are sweating like you're actually playing a sport." But no, all the laughs and all of those moments were very, very genuine, I think, from all of us.
And there's a still more sensitive side of this movie with the message of faith. What advice would you give to people who are struggling with this in these difficult times we are living?
I would say you're not alone, genuinely. I feel like this is a time where the whole world is trying to find our footing still with the circumstances that surround us and fighting this loneliness. And so I would like to think that feeling of hope and love and the fact that you're not alone and that there is a light at the end of the tunnel, you know, someone's always got you.
I second that. What Bailey said, finding who I am, it's a personal journey for everyone. But I think once you're willing and ready to take that journey, it can be a very rewarding experience.
Mm-hmm. For those who are looking for something to watch on Netflix, how would you recommend a person to watch A Week Away in just one sentence?
With friends, definitely with friends and family. It's a family movie.
Yeah. Yeah,
I'm going on. This is more than one sentence.
You should watch A Week Away. If you like a little dance, comma, a little song, just one sentence, I'm keeping it there. Love some like ha-ha moments, you know? And also if you're looking for a new repeat of a movie, you know, something that you can watch all the time and not get sick of. That was also a run-on sentence.
Thank you so much, guys, for this opportunity. And once again, congratulations.
Thank you so much. It was nice meeting you.
Thank you. Bye.